Welcome all students. Here in this course we are going to see the subject satellite communication. Subject code is 2171007 for BE 7th semester electronics and communication engineering student. Myself Professor Ravi Chauhan conducting this session on the behalf of Sri Swaminarayan Institute of Technology, Electronics and Communication Department. So, satellite communication. This subject is a advanced version of our electronics and communication and digital communication we have seen in our previous semesters. So, what we are going to see in this course? So, what type of fundamental we are going to see in this course? Are as follows. Over here with the help of this course we are going to understand the basics of satellite communication. We are also going to see the different satellite orbits. We are also going to see the satellite segment and earth segment. This course provides an in-depth treatment of the satellite communication systems operation and planning. This course is to analyze the various methods of satellite access. It can also shows the link budget and planning. This course review the stage of the art in the new research areas such as speech and video coding, satellite networking and satellite personal communications. Here, this course is to learn digital audio video broadcasting using the satellites. And in this course, we are also going to understand various applications of the satellite communications. So, it is very nice subject in your semester number 7. Our institute has offered this course as an institute elective. This course have many books, but some good reference book is mentioned in this slide, that Satellite Communication by Dennis Rudy and McGraw-Hill publication. So we take the reference of this book in our session. There are several books available in our college as well as our library, and also online books are also available. Some few books expect from this book is Satellite Communication System Engineering by Wheeler Pichard. Another book is Satellite Communication by Tremont Pat. And another book is Satellite Technology Principles and Application by Anil Mayani. So let us start this course. So our first unit is overview of satellite system. In this unit, we are going to see the overview of a satellite communication, introduction of satellite communication, different types of satellites, orbits, and its function. In this session, following topics are to be discussed. Introduction of satellite communication, basic parameters and concepts of satellite communication, application of satellites, frequency allocation of satellites, types of orbits, and examples. So let us introduce a satellite communication. Satellites are specifically made for telecommunication purpose. They are used for mobile applications such as communication to ships, vehicles, plants, handheld terminals, and TV and radio broadcasting. They are responsible for providing this service to an assigned region or area on the earth. The power and the bandwidth of these satellites depend upon the preferred size of the footprint, complexity of the traffic control protocol schemes, and the cost of guard stations. Satellites work most efficiently when the transmissions are focused with the desired area. When the area is focused, then the emission don't go outside and the designated area, as thus minimizing the interference to the other systems. This leads more efficient spectrum usages. Satellites' antenna patterns play an important role and must be designed to be best cover the designated geographical area, which is generally irregular in shape. Satellites should be designed by keeping in mind its usually for a short and the long-term effect throughout its lifetime. The Earth station should be in the position to control the satellites if it drifts from its orbit. It is subjected to any kind of drag from the external sources. So it is just a brief idea about the satellite, and we are also going to see the each and every unknown terms that we have discussed over here. So let's move ahead. Let's go for a basics. A satellite orbits around the Earth. Depending on the application, these orbits can be circular or elliptical. Satellites in the circular orbits always keep the same distance to the Earth's surface, following the simple law. The attractive force Fg of the Earth due to gravity is equal to m dot g into r capital R by small r whole square. The centrifugal force Fc trying to pull the satellites away equals to m into r into omega square. The variables we have following that m is the mass of the satellite, r is the radius of the Earth, which is equal to nearly 6370 kilometers. Small r is the distance of the satellite to the center of the Earth. G is acceleration of gravity with value of 9.81 meter per second square. Omega is a angular velocity with omega is equal to 2 pi f. F is a frequency of rotation. So it is very important equation. So to keep the satellite in our stable circular orbit, the following equation must be held. Means Fg is equal to Fc. Both force must be equal. Means if both force make their sums equal, then our satellite can be stable in our circular orbit. Looking at this equation, the first thing is to notice that the mass of m of the satellite is irrelevant. It appears in the both sides of the equation, so it can cancel out. Solving the equation for the distance r of the satellite to the center of the Earth result in the following equation. The distance r is equal to g into capital R square upon 2 pi f whole square into 1 by 3. From the above equation, it can be concluded that the distance of the satellite to the Earth's surface depends on its rotation frequency f, as shown over here. The important parameters in our satellite communications are inclination angle and elevation angle. These two fundamental important parameters are shown in our figure. Figure 1 shows the angle of inclination, which is defined by the angle between the equatorial plane and the plane described by the satellite orbit. As shown in over here, it is our equatorial plane, it is our plane of the satellite orbit, and the angle between these two planes is delta. It's called as a angle of inclination. Inclination angle means how our satellite orbit make the angle with our equatorial plane. Fine. Second is angle of elevation. An angle of elevation is defined over as a epsilon. Our inclination angle of a 0 degree means the satellite is exactly above the equator. If the satellite does not have a circular orbit, the closest point to the Earth is called as a perigee. Figure 2 shows the elevation angle epsilon, which is defined as it is the angle between the center of the satellite beam and the plane tangential to the Earth surface. Means it is our satellite cone, it is a distance between our Earth surface and it is a tangent of our Earth surface, and it is the angle between our satellite's cone and our surface tangent epsilon. A so-called footprint can be defined as the area on Earth where the signal of the satellite can be received. So angle of elevation, we can say that a particular area where the signal of the satellites can be received. Fine. So this is the important term to understand. So you can see that satellites are important, but where it can use. So the applications of the satellites are listed over here. First is weather forecasting. Certain satellites are specifically designed to monitor the climate condition of the Earth. They continuously monitor the assigned areas to the Earth and predict the weather condition of the region. This is done by taking images of Earth from the satellite. These images are transferred using the assigned radio frequency to the Earth station. Earth station is a radio station located on the Earth and used for relaying signal for the satellites. These satellites are exceptionally useful in predicting the disaster like hurricanes, monitor the changes of the Earth vegetation, sea state, ocean color and ice field. There are various applications of weather satellites. Second is radio and TV broadcast. This dedicates the satellites are responsible for making hundreds of channels across the globe available for everyone. They are also responsible for broadcasting live matches, news, worldwide radio services. These satellites require 30 to 40 centimeter size dish to make these channels available globally. Most important, military satellites. These satellites are often used for gathering intelligence, as a communication satellite used for military purpose, or as a military weapon. A satellite by itself is neither military nor civil. It is a kind of payload it carries that enables one to arrive a decision regarding its military or a civilian character. Means we cannot define a particular satellite as a military satellite. It is one type of a device which sends something, and we can use that sense data to our purpose. It can be military or it can be civic. Navigational satellites. The system allows for the precise location worldwide, and with some additional techniques, the precision is in the range of some meters. Ships and aircraft rely on the GPS as in the addition to the traditional navigation systems. Many vehicles come with the installed GPS receivers. This system is also used for fleet management of trucks or vehicle localization in the case of theft. So navigation satellite can also be used in our oceans, in our aircraft, or in our daily life. You are familiar with GPS is one type of navigation system containing 32 navigational satellite, which is owned by US. So another is UHF, contains 0.3 gigahertz to 1.0 gigahertz. L band contains 1 gigahertz to 2 gigahertz. S band have a frequency range of 2.0 to 4.0. C band have a 4 to 8 gigahertz. X band 8 to 12 gigahertz. Ku band, most frequently used in our satellite, is 12 to 18 gigahertz. K band also mostly used, have a range of 18 to 27 gigahertz. KA, most advanced satellite frequency range, is 27 to 14 gigahertz. V band have a 40 to 75 gigahertz. W band have a 75 to 110 gigahertz. A particular millimeter wave called as mm have a 110 to 300 gigahertz, and a micrometer is a 300 to 3000 gigahertz. So it is a just a frequency bands used in our satellite communication, or we can say that it is also used in our wireless communication. So it does not mean that this frequency is used only in a satellite. It can also use in our wireless communication at our surface as well as our space. Based on the satellite services, following frequencies allocate to the satellites. Frequency band in our gigahertz designation, VHF 0 to 0.1 to 0.3, particular use as a mobile and navigation satellites. So this shows the application of each band. L band have a mobile and navigation satellites. C band also a fixed satellite, and as I already told you, Ku band is a direct broadcast satellite for our TV transmission. So up to now we have discussed four things. First of all, introduction of a satellite communication, a brief introduction of a satellite communication. Then we have discussed the basics of satellite communication, basic parameter, basic equation, particular angle of inclination, angle of elevation. Then we have seen application of the satellites, different application of satellites. Then we have discussed the frequency allocation for the satellite for our each and every region and its services. So we have completed introductory session for this course, satellite and communication. Hope you have interested, and hope you have learned very well in this presentation. Contact if any query. Students, it is a International Telecommunication Union frequency band designation. Few of them we have discussed, and another terms are shown over here. Particular wave have its own symbol and its own frequency range. It is just for your information. Don't worry, it will not ask in exam, so it is just for your brief idea. Students, as per our previous discussion and over this session, following are some questions which you have to write in your notebook and send back it to me as per given direction. Hope you learn it well. Thank you. See you in the next session.